Hello everyone, welcome back to Invisible Ink, my solo playthrough as the wizard. We have a new spell page, and it's Hypnotic Gaze. I got annoyed with the fact that you can't, like, it tells you what spell it is, but it doesn't tell you what the spell does until you commit to buying it. So I went and I had to look through the mod files to see if I could see where the spells are defined so that I know what this is before I buy it. And I think I'm gonna not buy it. It's only 50 bucks, but like, 50 bucks here and there adds up, right? And I need agent upgrades. What this spell does, it's Hypnotic Gaze, is it's like a concentration spell that's, so it's active until the concentration duration ends, which is like forever. Or you concentrate on something else, or in this case, you break contact with the victim. So, eye contact with the victim. So basically a guard you can see becomes blind and deaf for as long as you can still see him. And then he goes back to normal. I don't remember if it, like, alerts him when you're done with that. I would hope not. But even if it doesn't, I don't think it's as good as Knock and Magic Missile. Like, I'm just not going to run this very often, I would think. Like, if it's a guard that isn't currently shooting at me, I can just kind of use distraction to get by him most of the time. And if he is shooting me, I'd probably rather have the magic missile, is my thinking. So, gonna grab that speed upgrade. That's all I get to do. What fun. Oh, I guess that's not true. I can also sell this spell page. Or, yeah, I think I'll sell it. I don't really want it. It's only 25 bucks. Oh, I guess instead of paying 50, I'm gaining 25. So it's really like 75 bucks to learn, in a sense, right? Okay. So next we can go to a server farm or another cybernetics lab. I'm going to take the server farm because I really could use another program, an icebreaker to spend my power on for cases when Parasite isn't fast enough. So I have way more power than I need. Look at that. A locked door. I could bash my way through it, but I don't yet have any particular reason to believe it will be desirable to go through. Oh wow, there's doors in every direction! Oh, is that good or bad? It would be better to have multiple agents, of course, but at least we kind of believe this is a little bit of a central area. That's good to know. I do have Lantern, actually. So I could get a good idea of what's going on back here. Okay. Well, that's good to know. I might have found that out by peeking, but also one of the things I was considering was sprinting, so that, like, if there was someone in this room nearby, they would hear me and I would hear them hearing me, and so I wouldn't need to peek. Wouldn't have worked on this guy. He's exactly outside of sound radius, so I don't know. On the one hand, I didn't get much for that lantern, but on the other hand, I kind of did. I think it's kind of nice to stand... Who is this, by the way? Just a normal guard. Oh, this is difficulty one, right? I think? So there shouldn't be anything too fancy going on. Oh, actually, with the layout of this room, I could just open the door and get in behind him that way, right? Because I'm in cover all around. Okay, that's fine. Ah! There's someone, like, right here. Investigating.
Must be imagining things.
You heard something. There he is. Ooh! He stopped the laser grid for me. That's nice. I stand here, I don't think he'll be able to see me from where he is, so I should be okay, right? What's with this? Is there shop here, maybe? I don't know. I think I want to see what's going on in this room. Security guard facing that way. I mean... Oh, yeah. This guy won't be able to see me, so that's fine. I don't really want to move from where I am. Yeah, I thought so. So this looks all right. I'll just follow him in here. Who needs cover, right?
Looking around. Absolutely.
And I did make sure I wasn't still inside the lethal grid. That was not a coincidence. I just forgot to mention that I was checking that. Oh, you know, maybe I should have sprinted there? Probably not. Is this the exit? No. I need to check for camera here, actually. I don't think there should be one, but it's not impossible. And that leaves me just enough AP to get here or here, either of which should be fine. Let's actually be here, I guess? So that... Because if I was standing here, and this guy came into this room, and then this guy opened the door, I might get spotted. With this layout, I'm in cover via the wall, and that won't happen. This guy is definitely going back into the room. So he'll turn around, and I'll be in his turning blind spot, and then he'll keep moving. That's the idea there. I guess I could be here... or here. Both of those are closer to this door. But as I said, this one's dangerous. This is closer to the door by half a move. Which could matter. If I stand here, though, I could open the door and re-peek. I don't think I care about that. Guards are so much more predictable without AGP. I think this sprint is probably good. It lets me know if there's someone over here. I guess I have Lantern, so I maybe don't need to take such risks. Let's just Lantern this area. No one in there. Cool. The power cost was refunded, right. But I... Out of curiosity, if you have, like, Lantern and Seed, does it give you a power... back, or does it say, nope, this was free, so you get zero power back? I'd be interested to find that out. I do need to peek, because while there are no guards, there could be a turret or camera. I don't think there should be a turret at difficulty one, though. Oh, actually... This sprint is a little dangerous, because I didn't get this far. There could be someone in here. Got away with it, although someone could patrol to here. It seems unlikely. So I already found three of the guards, and there should be like four or five. I always forget how difficulty one works. Every time I look it up, I just don't remember. Oh, the worst! Fine. I don't think there's much else I can do. I guess I can run here and repeat so I'm a bit closer when it's time to go in there. This camera's about to turn back on, but I'll be able to run through the room before it's on. I think I'll grab this. It shouldn't hinder me too much in getting out of here. Okay, went the wrong way again. I wonder if there are some, like, tells to map layout. I'm sure there are some. But, like, if there are some tells where I could have predicted ahead of time that this would lead to the exit. I don't think there's anything that blatant, but, like, maybe. I don't know. Okay. Well, high gear should be okay. And at least I've learned some stuff. Haven't looted a damn thing. I guess I got a couple of the guards. Where does this guy's patrolling from, like, here to one of these tiles, isn't he? I've lost track of where he was. What parity his patrol route has. I should be able, in principle, to work it out from first principles, right? Just play back in my head what I've done all mission to figure out where this stupid guard is. So turn one, I ended, like, here. Turn two, I got to here. Did I really go that fast? I think so. Yeah. And when I looked through this door on turn two, this guy was in here. Which means on even turns he's here, and on odd turns he's in this room. So sprinting to here will do me no favors. I just need to move slowly and live with it. And then maybe I can sprint in later. Maybe. He gets to, like, here or something, doesn't he? I could hit the shop, but he gets here, I remember. This is the other end of his patrol. So if I sprinted, I could get to the shop, but I don't even really have any money. And I would then have to also double check, what about the guard who patrols this area? Would he hear that and be a problem? Whereas if I just end my turn here, I'll be totally fine. I could open door peek, but I don't think I could possibly see anything good. And maybe somehow one of the guards in the guard who start, like, patrols this area, maybe he goes in here and I just didn't realize it, and opening the door lets him see me, so I don't want to do that. I'll do a closed door peek. Maybe I should have tried to squeeze more lantern value out. Okay, so these guys are kind of both down here. I could have lanterned up here last turn just to have it become off cooldown sooner while still getting an idea of what's happening in this area. I still don't think there's much going on here. Oh, you know, I guess I could be lanterning areas I'm not even in just to find out where the guards are and what their paths look like, right? But I would probably forget, so. Let's see. I think I want to sprint a little.
I heard something.
Okay, no one in here heard that. But I still want a lantern in. There's no one in there. Okay, so I'm not sure how great this is, but I'm going to sprint toggle this guy to here so that I can guarantee he won't be... I kind of am predicting this will be a small room. And if I want to come back in, I'd like him to not be where I just sprint toggled him to here. I don't know. This was sort of an inefficiently done turn, but... If I just let him go on his normal way, I could have gotten a little further in the room. And his normal path would be totally fine with me. I have to check in here. There could be a safe or two safes in here. Oh, shoot. Okay, there's nothing here. Because there can't be anything here. Okay. So this guy should be heading here now. So because I sprint toggled him once, he's now on the shifted pattern where he goes into this room on odd turns. Okay. Yes. Okay, and he goes all the way up into the corner. Now everything's going to take 100 years to hack with a dang old parasite. Boy, I left a lot of doors open, huh? These were sort of on purpose, although I don't know if they're a good idea. These, I guess... I could have closed all of those if I'd wanted to. I don't think it's wrong to have left them open, but it's kind of weird that I did it without thinking too hard about it. I mean, let's be real. Am I even taking this power? It kind of sucks right now, doesn't it? All right, so nobody can see this door, right? Where did this guy end his patrol? Is it here? If so, he can't see anything, but he could be like, if he's here, that would be a problem. Because he would notice me opening the door. I mean, I'd like to get to here, is why I'm talking about this at all. But I don't remember... I remember this guy stops his patrol inside this beam, but what part of it? Oh, I guess if I really wanted to, I could turn the beam on and kill him. Seems very bad. If it were not K&O, I could turn the beam on and it would ping off him and I would see where he is. But in K&O, the laser beams are lethal. I don't think I'm going to squeeze one turn, one step closer here. I'm going to leave the door closed and stay on this side of it, just to be safe. Yeah, I think he was here, so I think I could have gotten away with it. Okay, so we're at alarm level 2.5, and I've explored the exit, and I'm back to where I started. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I ran like this, I think I could full run. He would hear me on this, no. 1, 2, 3, 4. This tile. Which means he would want to come here and open the door and look around. But I could get to here, so I should be okay. And I definitely want to get that movement. That one point of movement. I only have half a move to spare, so I can't do something weird like here and then here or something. I have to go all the way across in the open. If there's any safes back here, like, too bad. I'm not taking them. I should have been lanterning in this area so I'd have lantern off cooldown sooner, but I didn't. Oh, he didn't open the door. Interesting. It's not what I expected. So we found three guards, right? Three? One, two, three? Yes. I'm just going to look it up again in the wiki, how many there are supposed to be at level one. Mission difficulty. Expert plus, difficulty one. There's just four guards and no camera drone. So there's one other human guard somewhere. One, two, three, four. So as long as I sprint to here, this guy won't hear it. Oh, right. Nice. I think this is a new update. It came with the last update to UI tweaks that if you have a ghost of a guard and it's confirmed via its location, in the sense that you could hit shift to see its vision, then you also get the sound notifier thingies. So it confirms for me that yes, he would hear this and not this. Oh, you know what? Let's lantern in here. Nobody. Okay. Good to know. I still need to peek in case of a camera staring me in the face. Okay. Alright, this can wait. Just slap a couple parasites on and pick it up on the way out. Isn't this guy gonna go, like, to this tile or this one or something? Shoot, I forget his patrol path. But he should be coming into this room now, right? And then he looks kind of diagonal, so yuck. I forget if it's here or here, but like one of these is where he ends his turn, as I recall. I think it's this one. So I'd kind of like to end my turn here, but obviously he would hear that, which is not ideal. So he would see this square directly, and this would be in his peripheral. I think I have to do something horrible, like end turn here. I hate it. Awful sprint. Oh, he actually goes all the way to be looking forward there, huh? Even worse. Well, I never did steal from this guy. I guess now's as good a time as any. Because I can't make much forward progress at the moment. And I want to end here, but I can afford to peek him as well, or observe him. Yes. Okay, way over there, that's fine. But I should remember that he's there. There's now a new unknown guard in this area, in addition to the three that we know about. So, I can't lantern yet. Probably just shouldn't sprint, honestly. This guy's got stationary written all over his face. I think I can get away with just walking in here, right? Because this space is hidden. And this space is also hidden. And he only has 8 moves, so if this is his interest point... Or actually, if this is... Which I guess is what would happen. I could arrange either one by either... Oh no, I'm going to have to close the door once I'm on the other side, so I can make this his interest point. But he can't get here. He only has 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and it would take 8.5 to get to this square. My understanding is that he should not... come here and then turn to face me as the end of his turn. He might walk all the way to here and then not turn, but he definitely won't get here. Anyway, the point, even if I come here, I should be able to get to this space and end my turn.
Did you see
there,
that?
Right? So even if I believed that he could somehow make it to this square, I can stand here and be safe. Okay, so I just need to have at least 9 power, and I want him to spend 3 on this stuff. I mean, I don't even need the console database. I don't know why I'm doing this. In fact, it was actively bad. Not just because it costs power, but because it reduces the number of devices I don't care about that Shopcat could put a virus on or a demon on when I'm done talking to her. Yeah, dumb. Should have let them keep the console database. Oh well. So this is the last... No, this card is probably a... Well... It doesn't say he's a captain, so I don't think he was spawned as part of the objective. He is very suspicious, being stationary right here, but I think he's not a captain, weirdly. I can't really get him anywhere very good sprinting, can I? I think just leaving him where he is my best play. Just pausing in case there's a camera here. You wouldn't think so, but I think it's possible. So if I hit one safe so far? Yeah, and I haven't even looted it, but okay. So I believe there shouldn't be any guards in here, but it's kind of free. In fact, it gains me power to lantern this, I guess. Yeah, nobody. Okay.
Looking around.
I could have headed over here so I could grab the programs before I head out, but I don't even have that much money. I need to loot the safes on this level before I can even buy the shit that they're... selling here. Fuck. I should have opened the door once I found out there was nobody in the area. This blows. Okay, well... I have enough movement to loot these and then walk away, or look at these at least, and then walk back, I guess, to relative safety. The primary is the one I want. Data blast would be nice, can't afford it at the moment. Lockpick 1? I mean, that's pretty sweet right now. Plague is just like Parasite on steroids. I don't need that. What is Split? Oh, so it's like... Huh. I assume it's on discovered devices, right? Not all of them? It would be way too good if you just, like, pointed this at a camera and it hacked all the cameras in the facility. And in that sense, it's not very useful to me, right? It's like lockpick 2, but... Well, no. It's like it's as efficient as lockpick 1, but if you happen to see other devices as the same of the same type, then it hacks them as well. But it's also less efficient than... or less flexible than lockpick 1. Because at least with lockpick 1, you can spend 2 power for 1 firewall. With this, you have to spend 4 for 2. I think lockpick 1 is, like, exactly what I want. I mean, Data Blast is so much better. Okay, well, let's look at the other terminal before I commit to anything. This will spread some demons, but tough shit. Can't help it. Oh. Well, I discovered a bunch of safes, I guess. Yeah, pretty much the only things left to put firewalls on because I hacked this thing like a dummy. What the heck is bank? Huh. Interesting. So... huh. This is an outlet for spending a large amount of power, right? To gain credits. Now, it says gain credits equal to the maximum firewall strength, but if it gives me 2 credits, I'm going to uninstall Wadzu's mods forever. I assume what he means is that it'll give you 200 credits. Because that's the highest... oh, 300. So, if I buy bank right now, I'm only out 100 credits. And the slot, of course. And that leaves me enough that I could buy lockpick, and then, like, sort of start working on these, right? Like, lockpick just the camera and parasite all the safes? I think bank is actually sick. Is there anything else here I would want instead? Why does this one say cost 3 power at the bottom? When, it, like, the cost is already at the top right for everything. I don't know, weird. Search is actually not bad. Because exploring is something that I'm not very good at, and search solves that problem pretty cheaply. I don't want lightning, obviously. I don't think poke is my jam. Yeah, I think I'm going to take bank and lockpick. 10x. Maximum firewall recorded. Okay. Wait a minute, really? Oh, it's a... what? This is completely different from what the hover text says. It says, passively, when you capture a device, gain credits equal to 10 times the highest firewalls it ever had. It didn't say it was passive when I was mousing over it, and it didn't say 10 times either. And it had a power cost, I thought, of like 8, right? I might have to rewind this. Well, now it says 8 power, but it does say passive, and I didn't notice that. I thought I could, like, point this at a device with a large number of firewalls. No, it does say 8. Passive. What does it mean for a passive to be to have cost 8? What? Does it mean when I gain the credits, it also charges me 8 extra power? I don't understand. I'm gonna have to go look through the definition of what this fucking program does. Maybe the modded reference guide will be enough. Hopefully I don't have to dive into the scripts. BRB. Okay, I looked it up in the modded reference guide, and then I went and read the Lua to confirm. Because even what it says in the modded reference guide is not exactly clear. It just says uses 8. Which, there aren't a lot of programs with uses. I wasn't sure what that meant. But the Lua is reasonably clear. The first 8 devices that you hack per mission, while you have bank installed, give you credits equal to, passively, give you credits equal to the most firewalls that device ever had. So, for example, when I finish hacking all these devices, 10 times the number of firewalls it ever had, I would get 20 for each of these is 60, 30 for this is 90. So, bank is like not going to make its money back in one mission. But I think it's a sound financial investment. And I can still afford to buy lockpick on my way out, but I am going to have to wait a while to hack all this shit. So, I mean, here we go. Are we still in high gear? Just barely. Arguably, I should have counted that before I spent all that power. And then if that this was going to take me out of high gear, I should have left this unhacked for a turn. But all's well that ends well. You're getting to, like, here or something, right? Sure. And so this 8 power cost is a lie. The ability is never clickable. It just this is a convenient place the game already knows how to display a counter. So this counter is how many more times it can trigger this mission is the idea. One, two, three, four. It's actually a pretty inconvenient. I should have ended over here somehow instead of here. I forgot that I was going to need to redistract this guy so he's not looking at this wall. I think this would only be in his peripheral, but that's still like a little bit closer than I would like. And it might be in his direct, honestly, because he's looking east from like here. What's the angle from here to here, man? 1, 2, 3 down by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sine. Oh, God. What is the sine? No. Yes? I have a right angle. A right triangle from here to here. Really here, actually. Is what I care about. So it's 3 up by, like, 9 over. And I want to know the angle here. Oh, I was so bad at trig. I mean, sine is the opposite over the hypotenuse, right? So it's opposite is 3. The hypotenuse is the square root of 9 squared. But I don't want to know the sine. I want to know the angle. I'm not going to look up the arc sine of whatever, of like about 3. Or no, it's about 9, right? No, it's about 1/9? That can't be right. It's about one third. Isn't that like 30 degrees roughly? So like, guards have a full vision cone that's 45 degrees wide. But that means in each direction it's only like 22 and a half. So I don't think a guard standing here could see this, except peripherally. I think I'm just gonna end my turn here, right? I don't think he'll see me. Oh, you know, I could have grabbed this. Instead of peeking, I could have grabbed this and come back. Whoops. Well, hopefully I don't need too much power. Yeah, it looks like he's not quite on angle. Ooh, lose 5 power, gain 20 credits. Gain 20 credits. Gain 20 credits, so that's 60, okay. Yeah, so he sees this square, but only peripherally. And he definitely can't walk over here in one turn. So if I just come in here... 4, 7, 8. He gets, like, here. If I just shut this door, he's gonna be ending his turn, like, here, and then he'll be no problem. It's a spell! My favorite! No more fucking cameras, please? Thank you. So these are all of the safes. No, there's one more. Because this I found but haven't opened. So, and then there's three here. So there's one more, I guess, in this room? Or maybe right here, shockingly. Better switch into low gear though, huh? Or we're gonna start leaking power. Should've grabbed this, as I said. The 2 extra power wouldn't be a huge differential. We've spent all the power we need to spend this mission, pretty much, so it's fine. Jesus Christ. Okay, well, I didn't mean I don't ever want to spend any power. So this guy we think is like here, right? He went from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8. He's here. So if I sprint... Oh, you know, don't forget, I do have knock. Which just opens a safe. It's very loud, and I don't want to be loud. And I don't actually know if it would trigger... Would it? Do you think it would trigger bank? I'm not sure. Because bank triggers when you break all the last fireball on a machine, a device. And I don't know what knock actually does. Ah, it reboots a safe. So no, it would not work. Got it. Okay. There's a guard here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So he shouldn't hear this square, right? And there's a guy here. He can't hear inside this room either. Okay, good. Just checking. Check for cameras. There's always bullshit. Some Wadzu bullshit. Where's the last safe then? Here or here? Or did I miscount again? 1, 2, 3, 4. No, there's another safe somewhere. Okay. I guess I could have unlocked this door. So that in case there's an item in the safe, I can carry it. But usually there isn't, because we're not playing with the pre-balanced safes from new items and augments. It's very rare to find items in safes in vanilla.
Investigating area. Guess it was nothing.
Also, I don't even really need to open this door because I want to duck back through here on my way out. Ooh. If I sprint, is this guy gonna hear? Surely I'm too far away for that, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, he won't hear that. But this guy will. Am I okay with that? No, it's very bad, right? Yeah, he would have a beeline straight to me. I could knock on this door just to make a lot of noise, but no one even hears it right now. And even if they could, I don't think it would be beneficial, but it's the kind of thing to think about. That's a way to produce a large amount of noise whenever that's useful. So, I mean, when I bought Bank, part of me was thinking that it was going to give me a ton of credits, but cost a ton of power. And I'm like, great, I have too much power, sign me up. Turns out, with all those siphons, I didn't have too much power, so it's kind of a good thing that it's passive after all, huh? We're gonna have to be on the lookout on the way back, because there's one guard who's been on the level for long enough that he could have filtered to pretty much anywhere. And then there's a new guy coming in, and I forget which of these doors, but he got there last turn, so he could be traversing over towards our area. Okay. How far can I get if I sprint? Well, the thing is, I can't just sprint for the door because I want to visit this stuff again, and I don't want to sprint when I visit this because he would notice me, which is bad. Or would it be bad? Because, see, he was here. 1, 4, 5, 6.5, 7.5. He should be like right here pretty much, right? Or no, I think a more efficient path for him actually might be to go this way. 1, 2.5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.5. No, I guess this is three away. This is, I guess, slightly closer, maybe? Because it's actually 2 root 2 away, where this is actually 3 away. But he's on, like, one of these 2 tiles. I can't conveniently make a noise that he would notice and that it would be useful to me, could I? But if I don't, he's going to go back to here and be looking east, which I guess means these would only be in his peripheral, right? So I could distract him again later. Okay, so if I go here, 1, I have 3.5 left. Not enough to get to this cover, huh? And this is the one I have to get to. I feel like there's not really a good way to handle this. If only I had paid 50 credits for that other spell, right? Well, 75. Then it would be kind of nice here, right? I could just tell this guy to go to sleep. And I could loot this stuff in peace. Uh, I think the best idea I have is to distract him to, like, here. And then back up to this cover or something. Okay, he's there. So this is a kind of nice place for him to be, right? And then I can hide here. I think that's the best idea I have. I haven't stolen from him. Now is the chance, obviously. Well, on level 5 is going to make things exciting, of course, but I'm a nimble scrambler.
Investigating area. Nothing.
So what do I want him to be looking at next turn? I think here's okay, because... Six... Well, is it? Maybe this was a bad place to stand. Well, we know from here he wants to go back along this route, right? But 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. He can actually get all the way back to his goal. So he would be looking east across the room if I left him alone, which is not great. I guess putting him here is pretty cool. Yeah, that's what I want to do.
Hold on. Did you hear something?
Because from here, I can get behind this cover and use that to escape. I hope. That's the plan, anyway. Okay, give me that damn lockpick, please. I guess I could afford Data Blast. If I buy lockpick, though, I will have enough money left to buy a useful upgrade. I don't know, Data Blast is so much better than lockpick. But, like, I'm not exactly struggling for power or to hack all the devices. I'm struggling for time. And so buying a speed upgrade or something seems like maybe the way to go. It might be criminal, but I kind of want to take lockpick here. I mean, Data Blast, I believe, costs less than 700 in vanilla, so Wadzu has rebalanced it to be more appropriately costed. I think it's still pretty good. I'm used to thinking of money as being sort of effectively infinite, because... Yes, you can't just upgrade everyone to level 5 right away, but you have enough that you can get upgrades while still buying useful stuff. And playing as just the wizard, man, I don't know, I've been under a credit handicap for a bit. That first mission really hurt. When I could get, like, almost no loot. We're starting to even the curve, but I still don't have so much money that I can just, like, say, oh, the extra $400 doesn't matter. And I think Parasite and Lockpick is probably good enough to get through anything reasonably comfortably. Should be able to stand here, right? I think so. Yeah, that seems fine.
Investigating the
area. Oh, good. Well, sort of good. At least I know what's happened to him.
Investigating area. Guess it was
that, I believe, is the guy who spawned at alarm level 4. The guy who spawned at alarm level 3 is somewhere in this nest of nightmares. I guess it's better to distract this guy here, right? I definitely can't make it out of the room this turn. I guess I could have, but I needed to peek on this guy, right? I guess I could lantern him and actually get out of here. But no, this guy goes back and forth. So either this turn or next, he's going to be looking at this door. So I can't... I clearly can't escape in either case. Okay, this is good. It means he'll be leaving. I just have to dart up there real quick. But alarm level 5 is coming. We're going to have to... be careful in our escape.
Investigating. Nothing.
There's the new guy.
What was that?
I could shut this door, but it won't matter. He's just gonna reopen it when he looks. So... I won't, I guess, is what I'm gonna say about that. It sort of feels like it should be more efficient to move here, right? To get to this side of the safe. It uses my movement more efficiently and gets me close to the safe, but actually this is a better place to be. Waste a half a movement this turn. Either way, you're 1.5 moves from the safe, and you'd rather be here than here, because this is closer to the door. Yeah, okay. Fine. What? Who the hell was... How did I hear someone throw a scan grenade? That's a surprise. Do I want to lantern this guy? It feels real bad. I think what I have to actually do might be like end my turn here so I can peek around the area. But this guy might have come out here actually, right? Let's lantern in here and see how bad it's looking. Okay, he's leaving. So this guy is probably entering the room, but 1, 2, 3, 4.5, 7.5. He could get to here, but in that case he still wouldn't see me. I think this is fine. Oh, we should switch into high gear again, right? Yep.
Checking things out.
It's interesting that he came this way and then looked here. His interest point is in this room, and it's like in that direction from him. So it's like this tile or this one or something? Maybe here? Right there, huh? Okay. Well, I obviously can't make much progress this turn, so let's just hang out.
Looking around.
In there, huh? Should be fairly safe standing here, I think. Let's peek this guy or observe this guy to confirm. He very well could be coming in here, but I don't think so. I think he's going to want to go this way, right? Yeah. You got to know guard brains inside and out, but when they're hunting, they want to go to the nearest area they have not yet hunted. And so in that way, they cover the whole facility. And, you know, this room is so large, it might contain multiple areas. I don't really know what counts as an area. For small rooms, it's a room. For big rooms, they might be split into multiple areas. But from here, the closest area that he hasn't been to by a mile had to be this one, right? So I was pretty sure he wouldn't come this way. And if he did, it would still be fine.
Investigating.
So what about the guy who scanned here? Where is he now? Ugh. He's around here, right? Well, there's plenty of cover, though, right?
Hey, investigate.
Wait a minute. This isn't the guy with the scan grenade. That's worrying. I don't know where Mr. Scan Grenade has gotten to. Also, I don't know if there's a safe back here. It would be nice to find that out, wouldn't it? I want to go out this way so I can hit up the shop. They're going to be notified of where I am, which is whatever. The two guards are by far the bigger deal. I guess I could lantern this area to figure out like if I'm going to have any issues. Sure, why not? Okay, don't want to be there, probably. What is his interest point? All the way down here? That's strange. Okay, that's fine with me, though. I think if the safe is on one of these two tiles, I'm gonna have to leave it alone. It's getting pretty scary in here. I don't remember how far this guy got in. Is it possible that he is in this room? Because that would, if he's in this room still, then he's kind of fine. I could just like knock on this door after sprint. No, I couldn't sprint through it and then knock on it, because I'd have to unlock it to go through it. I'm like one AP short of being able to bust through here and check out the shop. If this guy stands here, he'll actually have vision of the door I'm trying to get through, which I don't care for. Ah, but right now, remember, guards aren't allowed to use red doors. I'm so used to advanced guard protocol where they can. So I can use this guard door to my advantage, right? Because it's a door that currently is open to nobody, but I can open it and they can't. So I'm thinking if I redistract this guy to here, he won't have vision of this door next turn, so I can dash through it, right?
What was that? Investigating.
Investigating.
No one in here, please? Woo! Okay, but we look fine-ish.
What was that? Investigating.
Ooh, a little bit less fine, huh? I don't like that. Ugh. That is like real bad. Wish I had the lantern this turn instead, huh? I still could if I were to rewind, right? I don't see what else I can do short of murdering somebody, which doesn't seem so hot. If I did rewind, what would I do? How would I make use of the extra time? The do-over. I obviously wouldn't have to lantern to see where this guy's gonna end his turn. I could just safely end here last turn. Even maybe go in here? Ultimate greed? Seems dangerous. It's definitely this guy who will be coming for me. I don't see how any, like, noise on this door is gonna help me. Even if this were a safe and I knocked it, I couldn't really get to safety here. But after a rewind, I maybe could. If I were here, how, okay, so this guy is trying to get to this space, right? Or no, this guy. Oh, right, my sprint got this guy's attention, didn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yes. Wait, did I? But I didn't sprint. Never mind. So I don't know what this guy's doing. I happened to notice him, but he wasn't coming towards me. He might be, but I don't have any proof of it. This guy is coming for me. He's going to go 1, 2, 5, 6.5, 7.5. Oh, he only gets to here. Maybe that's fine? No. I don't think it's fine. Because he'll turn to face south. Well, yeah, the problem with that will be that while he won't actually be able to stop me from walking through the door, because he'll be standing here and facing south, this will only be in his peripheral. This guy's going to be standing here. And I suspect, but I'm not 100% sure, that this safe space sees here. So if I try to go this way, I get shot by you. If I try to go this way, I get shot by you. And actually, both of them. Well, yeah, both of them. Because, rather, one of them sees me, and that causes both of them to overwatch me. And then when I move, both of them shoot me. I do have dermal armor. I could survive getting shot twice if I had to. There's a thought, but I don't think it's a very good one. Right, I could end my turn here, start my turn by knocking on the door, then walk here, get overwatched twice, walk here, get shot twice, No, this doesn't work, because then they would have to open the door and get shot two more times. You can't open the door and walk through it as a single movement, a single action. Such niceties are for when there's nobody overwatching you. It's just a quality of life thing. Really, you're opening the door and then walking through it. They just don't animate that. If you click a movement path that takes you through a closed door. I could knock the door now, but I think that way madness lies, right? Well? Maybe not. Also, I suppose I could shoot this guy. I don't want to do it, but I could do it. And then I could escape the fact that this guy's looking at me, right? I don't know how safe this room is going to be. I could shoot him. What if I knocked this door? What would that line look like? It would attract the attention of these guys to this door. And then they would open it, and that would be bad. Right? I don't see how that could be useful. But I guess, like, I could rewind, maybe, and then knock this door with the plan to go around it, to go this way? I don't think I have enough moves, necessarily, for that on the previous turn. Right? I could just duck in here and wait for the storm to pass, but I don't even know if these are areas you can hide. They might be walls or more high cover. Probably not, because these are the same bookshelf prop, right? So they probably don't extend to here and here. But there might be, like, a safe and a console. No, that can't be a console. There could be a safe and a camera or something crazy like that in these corners, maybe? I mean, killing this guy does solve some problems. The problem is he's an enforcer, they'll just spawn another. Another problem is, this guy is surely, like, coming down here, right? What do I do about that? How far will he get? 1, 2, 4, 5, 6.5, 7.5. So he'll probably be, like, right here. Which is not bad. I could, if this guy were dead, I could probably get into this room. I guess I could hide here and wait till next turn to kill somebody? If it's necessary? Which I think it will be. It takes away my option to kill somebody again next turn, but I already don't have that. It takes away my option to recharge my spell next turn, but that's too expensive. I don't think I can do it anyway. So I only have one spell, or one magic missile in the near future anyway. So I think maybe just innocuously hide here, no rewind. Plan to kill one of the guys overwatching me so I can get out through, or one of the guys looking at this area so I can get out the door. But I don't have to commit to it yet. And this way I keep my rewind for some worse disaster in the future. Okay. So if we ignore this guy, I have a clear shot through this door. And I'm fairly sure this guy won't be looking, but it's possible he is. Likewise, if I ignore this guy, I have a different clear path through the door. So if I'm gonna kill someone, I can either kill the enforcer, who would draw some more attention over this way. Like, it would get this guy's notice, right? For some reason, he's inspecting himself anyway? I don't know. It would get this guy's attention, though, which would be quite nice. Hang on. Nobody can see me go through here. This guy's looking this way, but he doesn't have enough direct vision. Well, that's nice. I'm glad I delayed shooting somebody.
Hey, investigating.
I can afford a peek, yeah.
What was that?
Well, I can only sort of afford a peek. I want to end my turn here, right? I'm a little bit pinned down here. I'll be the first to admit it. I can't afford a gun. Nothing else does anything. An amplified buster chip or amped? I don't know what amp. I don't know, whatever. I see. Break four firewalls and gain a power. I don't think I need that. Yeah, none of this is anything. Okay, we're just gonna chill out down here for a bit. And I guess the last safe was in one of these two tiles. Hope nobody notices me. With the scan grenades, it could be tricky, but at least I can shoot them if they try. I still have magic missile up, right?
They're through here.
Oh yeah, they smashed the door. I should have left it open. But okay, no one else came this way. So how big a lantern can I get? Because if I can hang out for one... If I have to leave immediately, I can shoot this guy. But if I can afford a turn of dilly-dallying... Oh, really? You just happen to inspect... This happens so... I don't know. So often that I feel like it might actually be rigged. Is that, like, a guard happens to investigate the one square you're on. When there was no reason for them to target that specific square. Like, there must be something I don't understand. Because there's no reason for him to want to go to this tile. Right? Like, arguably, he might want to go in this room. Because, like, the last room he explored was this one or something. But why this tile? It's just so unlikely. Yeah, without his vision, this place is totally clear. With his vision, it's a living hell. I'm dead, right? So, I mean, I guess it's another case of, boy, I wish I had that... You know what? No, I don't know. I didn't really have enough AP to swap spells at any point. Like last turn, right? Maybe I could have saved two peaks and used those two AP to swap from knock to charming gaze or whatever it is. Hypnotic gaze. Because if I could just make this guy deaf and blind, I could walk out of here without killing him. So I'm about to pay $200 to kill this guy when I could have just spent $75 to learn a new spell and bring it along. And I didn't even spend my knock or my magic missile on this mission. So, like, I don't know. If I had brought Charming Gaze, I could be walking out of here without murdering anyone. But now it looks like that's impossible. There's nowhere I can go that this guy won't be a problem for me. So, I guess see you later. And I could sprint toggle to re-distract this guy, but I want him going the direction he's going in. So, I'm just gonna come out here and, like, live my life. There's no guard in here, right? I'm gonna peek just to be sure. Yeah. Whew. Okay, I mean, you know, everybody's done one murder, right? It's not really a crime the first time. Where was that last safe? Like, it has to have been on one of these tiles, which is crazy to me. Or did I just really miscount again? I don't think so. I did! I'm stupid. There were four down here and one up there. Okay, whatever. Don't at me in the comments about counting to five. I don't think I'll sprint. I'm just gonna hang out here with the door open, and if they see me, then I'll shut the door and run away. On my way out, it would be nice to know. Oh, I can't lantern them. I just thought it would be fun to see what they're up to. So, I don't know. I mean, a little bit of a disappointing mission in that I had to spend $200 killing somebody. But I got what I wanted, which was much better hacking tools. And, well, one better hacking tool and one money source. Those are both quite nice to have. I didn't use any magic at all. I was just a severely handicapped muggle. And I'm almost broke again. But, you know, we can afford to buy something, I imagine. What's this spell called? It's Hypnotic Gaze again! I'm being offered it again. Okay, maybe I'll take it this time. But that'll be next episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.